Hello and welcome to the January 2024 edition of Prairie Vistas. I'm Education Services Manager Tim Wollenzien.
And I'm Education Services Associate Nick Lero.
You know, this is a special episode of Prairie Vistas.
Why is that, Tim?
Because we're going to go over a series that's been quite notable for Prairie Public, Black Histories of the Northern Plains. With Black History Month starting in just a few days, what better time to showcase an excellent series that covers our region's Black history?
Topical, informative, and timely. For the listeners, could you tell us a little bit about the series?
Sure thing. Black Histories of the Northern Plains is Prairie Public's first exclusively digital series and was released in 2023. The four-part series chronicles the lives and stories of a variety of Black people who've played roles in the development of the Dakotas and Minnesota during the days of westward expansion. The series was created in-house at Prairie Public by a team of producer-director Matt Olien, writer Davin Waite, and host Troy Jackson II. Each episode, typically 7 to 8 minutes in length, covers a story that revolves around a Black person who played a significant role in the development of the region. York, an enslaved member of the Lewis and Clark expedition, is just one person featured in the series. As part of our mission to educate, involve, and inspire the people of the Prairie region, we've taken Black Histories of the Northern Plains, added educational resources to it, and uploaded it to PBS LearningMedia. With these resources, you can incorporate Black Histories of the Northern Plains into your classroom efficiently. Let's take a look.
Here we have the Black Histories of the Northern Plains collection on PBS LearningMedia, which I'd like to remind everybody is PBS's free-to-use educational resource database. All four episodes can be found here, as well as the educational resources we've created for each episode. Let's take a look at episode one. The first episode of Black Histories of the Northern Plains acts as a preamble to the next three, as it goes over the geographical history of the region, the people that lived in and those that began moving to the region, and the history of telling Black history in the United States. The support materials for episode one are located here. As you can see, the current support materials come in the form of discussion questions. The questions ask viewers to recall, analyze, and take it further. Recall questions, as they imply, aim to get viewers recalling facts and ideas from the episode. Analyze questions ask viewers to ponder how the elements of an episode work together. In this episode, they are in the form of cause and effect and compare and contrast questions. Finally, take it further questions get students thinking outside of the content of the video. For example, the question, please find examples in which instances of self-determination were evident in Black individuals in the mid-19th century, particularly during the pre-Civil War era. Who are these people and what challenges did they overcome? Could be an entire assignment connected to the episode. These questions in particular all fit that mold. However you choose to use the questions is entirely up to you. Coming very soon, probably by the end of spring, more support materials will be available for Black Histories of the Northern Plains, including further methods to use the series in the classroom. Curious about what standards these videos cover? You're in luck. A handy feature of Learning Media is the Standards tab, in which you can view the state and national standards that a resource satisfies. You'll only see state standards if you create a free account, so I highly encourage educators to do so. And of course, you can easily find the other videos in the collection on the side or on the bottom of the page. Now, Tim's going to tell you all about our partnership with the Northwest Services Cooperative, or NWSC, an organization that provides innovative programs and quality services to a variety of groups in the Northwest Minnesota area. Today, we'll look at their mini-course on Black Histories of the Northern Plains.
Here we are on the Northwest Service Co-op's page for their mini-course, which is, according to them, a short piece of heads-up information on a very specific topic, on Black Histories of the Northern Plains. In other terms, it's a self-paced course that acts as a guide to using Black Histories of the Northern Plains in the classroom that doesn't take too long to complete. If you were to complete three mini-courses, you would be rewarded with one CEU, or Continuing Education Unit. As you can see, there are five parts to this mini-course. Some you may preview without an account. Of course, in order to view the whole course and then complete it, you must create a free account. Now that I'm logged in, you can see that the view for the course changes. Here, you can see your progress in the course, which you're able to leave and come back to complete at your leisure, hence the self-paced label. The course is offered until January 3rd, 2025, so make sure to enroll and get your CEUs this year.
As part of our look at Black Histories of the Northern Plain, I've interviewed Matt Olien, who produced and narrated the series. I've asked five questions that clarify the origins and development of the series, as well as how it could potentially be used as an educational tool. The stories presented in Black Histories are ones that are rarely told. How did you hear about these stories?
So I heard about them because I was brought in as kind of a last-minute producer on this series, because Davin Waite had done all the research for these stories, but he was leaving Prairie Public. And so I was brought in because John Harris thought that a TV producer needed to kind of finish these and make them look good and that kind of thing. So, because Davin and Troy weren't really trained in that thing. So that's how I heard about them first. I really had no knowledge of the Bongas or York, you know, the slave that went with Lewis. Some of these other stories, the man who founded the town in Minnesota, you know, that came from Alabama or Mississippi, wherever he was from. I had not heard of any of these stories at all. So the fact that Davin had kind of researched all this and found this was kind of eye-opening, because again, these are stories that we don't learn about going to school. I never knew about any of these things growing up in North Dakota. And so that's how I heard about them. And I was brought in to kind of, you know, do these four stories and kind of research them more and find images we needed and finish them up.
What was that process like, researching the stories?
So Davin did the majority of the research and wrote the scripts. And then what I had to do was kind of edit down the scripts because they were too long. And you have to kind of economize things in television and make them presentable to the public and not too confusing. So I had to edit them down. And then John Harris and I would kind of go through them and watch them. And then there was an editing process as well. But he did the majority of the research. I did do a little bit here and there to kind of finish up the scripts, but Davin deserves most of the credit.
Are there any stories that were left on the cutting room floor? And if so, could you describe them a little?
Yeah, Davin and I had planned a segment, another segment, or a fourth or fifth one on these barbers in Moorhead that were African-American. Early, you know, haircutters and barbers in Moorhead, but it was almost impossible to find any. There wasn't enough photos, images to really do a 4 to 5 minute story on those. So we kind of dropped that one. That would have been interesting to do, but it would have required a lot more research than the time we had.
Why do you think the stories of Black history in this region are important?
Like I said, I didn't grow up knowing about any of these things. I didn't know about the Bongas or the Barbers or York at all until I started, you know, producing these shorts. And I think that shows how, I don't know if it's a conscious decision not to teach these things in schools, or it's just not on our forefront of our brain. I just think a lot of people have no clue that there were Black people in Minnesota and North Dakota in the 1800s. We just assume it's, you know, Scandinavians and Germans and English and things like this. And so it's important to tell these stories and let people know that there were people here that really made a difference up in this area, because they were either leaving a part of the country they didn't want to be in, or, you know, with the Bongas and the fur trade and all that kind of thing that was so interesting. So that's why I think it's important to learn more than what we think we know about this region.
Lastly, how do you envision teachers using this series in the classroom?
So I think they could show certainly all four of the segments in their classrooms and have the kids do some further research, or I just think it would be eye-opening for most kids to see these stories, because I'm guessing if I didn't know that they were out there, I doubt if they knew either that they were out there. So I can see them using the videos that we've created as resources and learning materials, and maybe have the kids do some more research from that and do, you know, find out somebody else that we didn't feature that made a difference in the early 1900s or late 1800s in this region that was, you know, not Scandinavian, not German, people are accustomed to in this area.
Finally, before we sign off, we'd like to point you in the direction of other resources that fit the theme of Black History Month. We've got three high-quality resources for you to check out that cover a wide variety of ages and topics.
First is the Celebrating Black History and Culture collection on PBS Learning Media. Here, you'll find resources for secondary students that cover the topics of literature and media, the arts, civics and society, as well as STEM.
For the youngsters in pre-K and kindergarten, PBS Learning Media has Learning About Black Leaders Bingo, which is really just part of a larger packet of printable, hands-on activities for young students to help them learn about black history.
Finally, there's this excellent list of black scientists, primarily geared towards secondary science teachers, that contains not only 10 monumentally important figures in American history, but also further resources for you to learn more about them and bring them to your students' attention.
Well, that was an interesting and informative dive into some really excellent content.
I agree, and to anyone out there listening to us, we encourage you to check out these resources discussed today, all of which are linked in the description and on our website, prairiepublic.org. Tim, what are we going to talk about next month?
Next month, we're covering Minnesota's legacy and all the wonderful educational resources it has funded since its inception in 2008. One of those resources just happens to be Black Histories of the Northern Plains. If that gives you any indication of the quality of content that Minnesota's legacy produces.
Excellent. Keep your eyes open to our social media pages on Facebook and Instagram, as well as our monthly newsletters to stay up to date on what's next with the Education Department.
Thank you to Matt Olien for the interview, and thank you for listening. From Tim,
Nick,
and the rest of Prairie Public, have a cool and educational day. Learn something.